come join Rosie and me as we cruise on Serenade of the Seas, January 7th through January 23rd, 2010. Our 14-day cruise included 2 7-day cruises, and we did them back-to-back. We departed out of San Juan, Puerto Rico, and hit the ports of St. Thomas, St. Croix, St. Kitts, Dominica, Barbados, came back to Puerto Rico, and went out again, and did Tortola, St. Martin, Antigua, St. Lucia, and Grenada. Our vacation started January 7th in the middle of a snowstorm. After 3 flights, 3 flight delays, and 18 and a half hours, at 1:30 a.m. Friday morning, we arrived in San Juan. In San Juan, we stayed at the beautiful Marriott Hotel and Casino. Friday featured on and off showers, but liquid sunshine is much better than snow. At 6 o'clock in the lobby of the Marriott, we met people that we had been chatting with on Cruise Critic for over a year. Don and Lou were the virtual reality mom and dad of our group, The Maniacs. At around 7:15, our group of 6 walked to the Angel Cafe to meet up with the rest of our group, where we would have dinner with a small, intimate group of 25. The more maniacs, the better. Saturday, January 9th, at 11:30 a.m., we got in a cab and made our way to the port to board the Serenade of the Seas. Waiting outside in line were Walt, Betty Ann, Debbie, and David. Serenade of the Seas is a spectacular ship with 13 decks. The 13 decks feature a 10-story glass-constructed centrum, glass elevators facing the sea, a rock climbing wall, 2 specialty restaurants, Portofino and Chops, a casual Seaview Cafe, many themed bars and lounges, a casino royale, self-leveling pool tables, a beautiful outdoor pool, as well as an indoor solarium, Adventure Ocean, a youth facility, as well as a sports court that features basketball and volleyball. Join Rosie and me as we sail on Serenade of the Seas in Cabin 1100. Cabin 1100 is a junior suite with a large queen-size bed, a queen-size sleeper sofa, and chair and ottoman. The aft balcony is approximately 12 feet wide at the wide end, and 3 feet wide at the narrow end, and 17 feet in total length. At 3 o'clock p.m., many of the maniacs met at the Sky Bar for an impromptu get to know you. Docked aft to aft with the Celebrity Summit, and at 8:30 p.m. it was time for sail away. 9 o'clock, Rosie and I had dinner with Jay and Trish and Lorraine and Richard in the casual Windjammer Cafe. Sunday, January 10th, we're in St. Thomas. 83 degrees and sunny for today. St. Thomas, once a bustling haven to swashbuckling pirates, today is a tropical outdoor playground. It has magnificent beaches, crystal clear water, and exciting activities. Since our Sea Blaster excursion was canceled, Rosie and I spent the afternoon in a bar. At 3 p.m., it was time for our cruise critic meet and mingle, with close to 100 participants signed up, over half of which were maniacs. At 8 o'clock, we had dinner in Portofino, the fine Italian specialty restaurant. Monday, January 11th, we're in St. Croix. It's another beautiful day, sunny, with a high of 84. St. Croix is filled with gentle hills, turquoise waters, and white sandy beaches. We made our way from Frederikstad to Kristianstad across the island for our excursion, a snorkel trip to Buck Island. The Buccaneer. Rosie and I stayed here in 1999 after a sailboat trip in the British Virgin Islands. After sail away, Rosie and I had dinner at Portofino with Debbie and her, and Betty Ann and David. Tuesday, January 12th, we're docked in St. Kitts. It's another gorgeous day with a high of 83 degrees and a few light passing showers. Our shore excursion was called Catamaran Fantasy. We sailed on one of the locally built maxi-cats along a truly scenic and unspoiled coastline, with mountains and secluded beaches on one side and the open Caribbean Sea on the other. After a short and invigorating sail, we stopped at a protected cliffside cove for snorkeling. After our snorkeling, our trip continued across the Narrows, a 2-mile channel that separates St. Kitts from its sister island of Nevis. We enjoyed spectacular views and then stopped for lunch on Pinney's Beach.